We have great confidence in our son. I am not concerned about any accusations been made against him. It's used to get to me. It is what it is. And he's a grown man. He is the smartest man I know.
Joe Biden has defended Hunter constantly throughout all of his craziness.
It was like,
what's also fascinating is how the media has covered this. Can you just imagine if this was happening on the other side, how the media would be looking at that? Listen to this.
There's no evidence that Hunter Biden has done anything wrong.
There is no evidence of any wrongdoing by Biden, by Joe Biden, or by Hunter Biden.
There's no evidence that Joe Biden actually did anything wrong or did anything to sway things in Hunter Biden's favor. He's denied that his son ever lobbied him for anything. There is nothing wrong that Vice President Biden did.
President Trump has falsely accused your son of doing something wrong while serving on a company board in Ukraine. I want to point out there's no evidence of wrongdoing by either one of you.
There is no evidence that anybody did anything illegal regarding the Bidens.
I want to set this up by saying there's no sense in building straw man arguments or building narratives just for red meat audience. That's not what I want to do. So just so you know, the only reason I'm bringing you this story is because I think it's actually going to be a thing. To what extent, I don't know. Grandpa Joe, President Biden, I think, is eventually going to get pulled in to the Hunter Biden tax financial investigations. There's a lot of other did he or didn't he, what did he know, when did he know it, all that sort of stuff. But new emails that surfaced coming from the Daily Mail make it seem pretty tied together that Joe Biden and Hunter Biden at the very least shared a bank account. If they did, I think the president is going to inevitably just get pulled in to Hunter's financial craziness. The whole laptop story came out right before the election. Every social media platform censored it. The New York Post got taken down from Twitter for like a week and a half because they refused to remove the story that ultimately turned out to be true. Emails were covered by DailyMail.com from Hunter's abandoned laptop between Hunter and Eric Schwerin. His business partner and consultancy, Rosemont Seneca, shows Schwerin was working on Joe's taxes, discussing the father and son paying each other for household bills, even fielding requests for a book deal for the then vice president, as well as managing the donation of Joe's Senate papers to the University of Delaware. Daily Mail goes on to say it's unclear why Schwerin had this intimate role with the vice president's affairs rather than government officials in the office of the vice president. Last December, Hunter admitted in a public statement that he was under federal investigation over his tax affairs. There's a pretty intermeshed financial working between Hunter Biden and Joe Biden, which again is the only thing that is needed to pull President Biden into the fray. A former federal prosecutor and expert on money laundering and criminal tax law tells DailyMail.com that if money was flowing between Hunter and his father, that could make Joe the target of the probe, but that investigators would have a tough time sitting down with the president. But he said, whatever transaction you're looking at, if there's a connection to a family member or a friend, sure, the answer is yes, they would be investigated, the ex-prosecutor who would not be named said. Obviously, if you're talking about the President of the United States, he says, you'd better have a pretty damn good reason to talk to that person. Hunter is being investigated. Now emails are coming out that Hunter and Joe had some intermeshing of their bank accounts. He goes on to say that corruption is a predicate offense for money laundering. And besides corruption, it's the perception of corruption. This kind of thing should not be happening. Again, it undermines full faith in the US government and undermines trust in our international reputation. It's an embarrassment. And yet more evidence of the deeply commercial relationship between Hunter's firm and the vice president's office during Joe's tenure, Rosemont Seneca received special favors from the White House while Joe was in office, including dozens of tickets to exclusive White House events and private tours for Rosemont Seneca clients and associates. I do want to make the point that for the last 5-6 years, MSNBC, CNN has been talking about this is the day that the Trump tax policy or the Southern District of New York or whatever it is going to finally get Donald Trump. Never came to fruition. Maybe it will someday, but to this day, it has not. So I want to be leery of that when we're talking about the Hunter and Joe Biden situation. Maybe nothing comes of this. Who knows? But it is fascinating where this is going and all the new developments that are coming up.